Okay, let me know if I'm running out of time because I really want to get to question three, and if I don't, I'll skip a bunch of stuff to get there if I need to.
Okay.
Okay, my presentation is on Big the Cat. Yeah, no one saw that coming. All right, for those of you who don't know, Big the Cat is a character from the Sonic the Hedgehog video game series. He first appeared in 1993 in the video game Sonic Adventure and later appeared in 2003 in Sonic Heroes. He also appeared in a couple other stuff, namely these, but those are just minor cameos. He didn't even talk in most of them, so none of them count. Except for that one, but that one doesn't count either for reasons I'm not going to get into. Get it out of there. It doesn't count. Okay, so let's talk about the character. Big the Cat's personality traits in order of importance. First of all, we got loyalty. He is brave. He is easygoing. He is a skilled fisherman. He is athletic. He has a mental disability. He was trained as an Olympic referee at some point in time. Just an all-around real complex character. And you're probably thinking, I just buried the lead big time there, didn't I? Mental disability, shouldn't that be way higher up? No, not really. Remember this timeline? Never gets brought up in any of these games, ever. Except for that one. Does not count. Anyway, so, and that's kind of what I love about this character. They treat him exactly like all the other characters. He does everything the other characters do. He, you know, runs fast, jumps high, fights robots, takes out terrorist dictators' war machines, you know, all the stuff all the other characters do. And again, his mental disability is never once referenced, alluded to, discussed. He's never treated any differently from any of the other characters. So you're probably wondering immediately, how do you even know he has one? Because of the way he's acted. I got some clips.
Is he a Swiss?
Not yet. I got some clips here, and you already started to hear it, but this is an able actor doing a disabled character, and it's pretty cartoony and stereotypical, so it might be a little hard to listen to. But here's what they were going for.
You need a switch to open this door. Gotta be a wall to break. Let's look around. I want to find Froggy and go fishing.
Yeah.
That's a no-no, Doctor.
Okay, so elephant in the room, question number one, is that offensive? Yeah, kinda, but let's hear from you. And why? Thoughts? Yes.
I think not only is the voice offensive, but the words that he used. Like, they were like, is that a no-no, Mr. Whatever, instead of like being more.
Yeah.
I
completely agree. The only reason I don't think this is absolutely, completely, unredeemably offensive is the fact that it is not portrayed as ever being a joke. Like, you are supposed to take the things he says seriously the entire time. Like, one of those was, you gotta find a switch to open the door. The player is supposed to immediately start looking for a switch, because that character is portrayed as being a helpful source of information. And again, he's always well-respected by the other characters. But he still has that voice, yes?
Do the other characters, when they talk, do they talk in a more complex, like, way?
Yes, they do. Okay. They speak quote-unquote normally.
So do they use him for, kind of like, in the video game, like, things that you're supposed to do, like, immediately, or like...
Oh, no, they all do that. Throughout the entire game, everyone's constantly giving you advice. Some people find that annoying, actually. Okay, any other comments on his voice? Nope. Okay, I really want to get to point three, so we're going to kind of go through point two kind of quickly. Dolmage's disability stereotypes. He or she had 10, I think, stereotypes. I'm just going to go through them all really quickly and say whether or not they apply to this character. Disability is a pathology. They always get diagnosed. He never does. Kill or cure. He's still alive. He's not cured. Disability is an object of charity or pity. Nope. This physical disability. He has mental. Disability is a sign of social ill. He's a nice guy. Nothing bad ever happens to him. Nothing bad ever happens. Nothing bad ever happens. Nothing bad. Oh, wait, no. Okay, physical and mental are always intertwined. He is just mental. He has no physical disabilities. Disability drop, he's not faking it. Okay, this one actually needs some explanation. Disability is isolated or individuated. They always portray disabled people in media as being alone and can't really connect with people, sometimes even living alone in the jungle. He has friends. He has close friends. He has a best friend. But he totally lives alone in the jungle. To be fair, they portray that as being his choice, like he does just because he likes it, there's good fishing. You see him in cities, he wakes up fine there. It's not because he has to. But that doesn't change the fact that they put the disabled character living alone in the jungle. There's a discussion to be had there. But instead, we're going to discuss this one, overcoming a compensation, aka the super quip. Professor Xavier is a wheelchair user, but he's telekinetic. Big the Cat has a mental disability, and he's kind of strong. So that seems textbook super quip, except for the fact that kind of everyone in this universe can do that. You know, this guy can do that, 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 this girl can do that, this guy can do that. All these robots could also do that.
Is there only one girl?
I kind of think Amy Rose could probably also do it, but this is just the ones that I saw in list of power characters on the wiki. I didn't do that much research. I did a ton of research. So, here's the question number two. Does he count? In the context of the world's universe, he's not actually that special, but looking out, they did just give the disabled character literal super strength. Isn't that textbook definition? Super quip? Thoughts? Given the context, no? It depends on what matters more, external logic viewing going in or internal logic, how the characters, you know, view him. Any other thoughts? Okay, so, why I chose this character is because when I first played the game, I was very confused about why they had a mentally disabled character front and center, and they never discuss it, and they treat him like everyone else. You know, I was a kid, and I thought, it seems wrong for some reason, but I couldn't exactly place why, and it almost got me to rethink the portrayal of disability in the media as a whole, until I did research on this character and I found out that everyone hates him. Yeah. So I just stopped thinking about it. I was like, okay, bad character. That's it. And everyone hates him. Here's a clip from an IGN show, GameScoop. If you don't know, IGN is the world's biggest source of video game journalism of ever right now, all right? They are supposed to be the peak of journalistic professionalism and integrity, and here's how they talk about this character. Oh, actually, the discussion is about why people like the series as a whole, but they bring him up.
I don't know, I don't really understand why, but there is a segment of the gaming community that really, really loves Sonic.
Sonic is never good. If you disagree, you can call the cops.
Also, the reason is they all want to have sex with Big the Cat.
That's true.
That is still the reason. I said it now or go, I'll say it again.
That was from the top generalist site for video games in the world. They felt comfortable putting that out. So yeah, the character is despised and people feel the need to take pot shots at him wherever. And when people feel the need to take pot shots wherever, they get a bit nasty. In Vice's article, Sonic the Hedgehog Needs to Die, they described the problems with the game Sonic Adventure. One of those problems, they said, was the mentally handicapped imbecile of Big the Cat. And note the wording in the sentence. They say he's a problem, and the only justification they give for him being a problem in that game is because he's disabled. They felt comfortable printing that, and I looked. As far as I can tell, there was no backlash at all. And you may have noticed mentally handicapped imbeciles in quotation marks. You know why? Because that comes from another article. In Destructoid's review of Sonic Adventure, they said the same thing. Except, to be fair, they just said that he seemed like a mentally handicapped imbecile. So that's, better. And again, I looked for the backlash. I found this one guy, or girl, Candace, and nothing else. That was the only person who said, wait a second, that's not cool. Alright? And I was able to eventually find something with a little bit of with a lot of backlash. Remember that IGN clip I just showed you like 30 seconds ago? That currently has 11,000 downvotes on YouTube. One of which is from me. Anyway, they got a ton of hate comments, which I can't show because they're full of swear words, but a couple from people who actually worked on the game, so that's cool. But more importantly, they got a bunch of response videos of people saying, you know what, it's not cool to use a fictional character to bully real-life people. That's not what journalists should be doing. And you know what happens when there's a backlash? This is super offensive. I'm going to show you a tweet. Be prepared, it is very offensive, and this is not just some guy. In response to all those video responses, this guy on Twitter says, IGN said Sonic wasn't good, so now there are tons of reaction videos that give a profound window into the inner workings of the autistic mind. For those of you who don't know, that is a common stereotype people use with Sonic fans, that they're autistic. How common? Someone said it to my face once. So he goes on to say that, you know what, that was not really important. And he says that he'd link it, but he wanted to be able to laugh at these people, the autistic people, quote unquote, down the line, and he didn't want them to delete the videos because people were laughing with him. This guy has 270,000 subscribers on YouTube, 60,000 followers on Twitter. This comment got 426 likes, 90 retweets, and not a single comment telling him it's not cool. I know, I checked all of them. And anyway, like I said, this isn't just some guy. This guy, to be fair, he wasn't when he wrote this, but he now has a job creating a weekly web news show with Destructoid. You may remember them. They're the one who said Big the Cat seemed like a mentally handicapped imbecile. So, question number three. Why? Why is this character such an easy target, and why are we as a society so able to just kind of let people get away with super blatant ableism in our media? Yes.
For some reason, I feel like, especially when it comes to video games, that they kind of have this, like, leeway that they can be, like, a little more offensive. Like, immediately, like, I thought of Grand Theft Auto. Like, when Grand Theft Auto first came out, I was like, how is this even a video game? And, like, stuff like that. And so I just feel like every time I watch anything about, like, gamers or gaming, like, they kind of always use, like, super offensive language, whether it's, like, something to this or, like, something else, but they're very uncensored.
I guess part of the culture. That's a good point. I didn't think about that, but, yeah, they kind of, yes?
It's particularly a large population of cishet white males who are misogynistic, who are small-minded, and a lot of them lack maturity. So they go after anybody they view as somebody weaker than themselves. It's a pretty hateful culture.
Alright. Any other ideas? About why we accept this society? Yes?
I guess it's like similar to when we were speaking about people with disabilities. We're kind of dissociating from like they are humans too. Mm-hmm. So like basically what happens is that like they're kind of disconnected from the fact that we are talking about like a diagnosis that people do have, so it's like they feel more comfortable that there's not a human attached to it. Because it's different with someone who is
disabled. All very good ideas, yeah. It's very insightful. Alright. Do we still have time? I got
no.
One. No? Okay, that's a good place to stop in.
How many slides do we have on that?
Oh, that was slide 41.
Thank you very much. For those of you guys who don't know but are interested in graduate school, you can